This is number 90, a Baldwin-Tuckett pond built for the Great Western Railroad in June of 1924. Strasburg purchased her in 1967 from the Great Western and has worked on the railroad for almost 10 years now. On June 17, 1978, a one-time, one-day event was going to happen, and number 90 was the star. She would be painted back into her original Great Western colors and would pull a special photo freight for rail fans and train enthusiasts. We had her cameras rolling and got the best seat in the house, so sit back and relax as we see the 1978 Great Western Extravaganza in action. Here we see number 90 at the shop crossing getting her tender topped off with coal for the events later today. Here we see number 90 gently coupling up to her train at the Strasburg station platform. The crew put this consist together of three coaches and all of the freight cars that they had in the yard. And number 90 will depart shortly, but we have to get all the rail fans and the enthusiasts on board first. Here we see the passenger cars up at the station end. A lot of nice, lovely folks decided to drive out their 1950s cars today for the photo freight. Number 90 slowly pulls out of Strasburg Station and is on her way down to Lemon Place Junction. Here we see number 90 in the consist at the Red Caboose Motel. Today, number 90 is supporting a Crosby 3 chime, which is way more different than the Reading 6 chime you usually hear when she's on the Strasburg Railroad. Here we see number 90 at Cherry Hill. Here we see number 90 crossing the only bridge on the line, which is simply a farm lane. Once the train made it to Lehman Place Junction, the crew switched the cars around to put the passenger cars in the back for the photo run-bys. And here's number 90 doing the first run-by. Number 90 then backs the consist down, and they do another run-by, with number 90 outperforming herself again. And once more, number 90 backs the train down for one more run-by at this spot. Number 90 then takes the consist to Carpenter's Crossing. Up until 1987, every train crossing Carpenter's had to be flagged, since there were no crossing gates or warning lights warning automobiles or motorists that were flying over the hill that there was a train there. Since number 90 is doing a photo freight and she's going to be showing off a little bit, the crew pre-flags the crossing to make sure that the motorists definitely know that there's a high-speed steam locomotive headed towards them. The crew then drop off the photographers and filmers who went to see number 90 fly by at Carpenter's. Then we take our spot to see the first run by. The crew this time took number 90 almost into Gross Grove, but just stopped her right before her, so we got this really neat shot in the field. Next, the crew decided to drop the passengers off and shove the coaches into the siding at Groff's. We climbed again into another field to get this beautiful scenic shot of the grass and the trees and number 90 right in the middle. After the last run by at Cherry Hill, number 90 and the crew coupled up to the coaches and was headed back for Strasburg. Here we caught our Espenshade crossing. Number 90 was uncoupled from her consist and back down the runaround track and stopped right next to the parking lot to have a photo opportunity with an old car. Thank you for watching. The models used were made by K&L Trainz. Please support them and check them out at their website, knltrainz.com.